I stuck by ya. You're a sunflower. I think your love would be too much.
This is a claw hammer with a metal shaft and molded rubber handle for improved grip. This is how you should hold the hammer, at the end of the handle and not near the neck, like this, where the hammer becomes less efficient. To drive a nail into timber, you use a couple of very light taps to get the nail to stand up on its own. Then you remove your hand and drive the nail home. With practice, you'll be able to hit the nail on the head every single time. Even with small nails, the method's still the same. A few light taps, remove your hand, and then drive the nail home. To remove a nail, you can use the claw like this. If you need to, protect your workpiece with a scrap of timber. If the nail is long or difficult to remove, place a block under the claw. This method gives you greater leverage and less effort is required to pull even the biggest nails. This is routine maintenance. Keep the face of the hammerhead clean and it'll be less likely to slip and damage your work. Rub it on a bit of abrasive and it should look like this. This is another way to hold the hammer. Use the side of the hammer when you need to work with a chisel. The chisel must have a shatterproof handle like this one. The claw must face away from you to minimize damage to your hand. You'll need to use the side of the hammer when chiseling because it's bigger than the head and it's less likely to miss. What you mustn't do is use the hammer like this because you will miss and you're very likely to injure yourself.
Para hindi na ko babiyahe, sayang pamasahe, pati ang chocolate sa'yo.
In this video, you will learn how to use a mallet. The mallet is a hammering tool made with a striking face that is usually made of wood or materials softer than steel. Mallets provide better transmission of force due to minimal rebound off the struck surface. A mallet has a large head that is made of dense hardwood in order to carry out heavy work without causing damage to the items or tools being struck. The mallet has a large, flat striking surface to ensure a square hit. The handle is wedged into a through mortise that extends through the middle of the head. It is essentially used for hard work, such as driving a chisel against the grain. Mallets are also used in assembling or disassembling joints that lock together with a tight fit. To apply a powerful blow, grip the handle of the mallet near the base of its handle. Take a long swing, using your arm, not just your wrist. For more control on delicate jobs, choke up towards the hammerhead and take a shorter swing. Here, you can swing from your wrist. When chiseling down a vertical plane, for example, when squaring a mortise, a wooden mallet can deliver the required cutting force to the chisel. Remember to strike only on the face or peen of the mallet and never with the side. Make sure the chisel is held straight and give a firm tap with the mallet. One firm tap is often better than many light taps, as the chisel may tend to move around. Once your mortise is ready, you can fit a tenon into it using the mallet to apply light blows. Remember not to use a wooden mallet to strike anything metallic or sharp like a nail. You have now learnt how to use a wooden mallet.
And now I'm taking these shots like it's normal, hey. Yeah. Ooh, I fall apart down to my core.
In this video, you'll learn how to use a screwdriver. The screwdriver, as the name suggests, is used to drive screws into surfaces. Screwdrivers vary on the basis of their tips, as this determines the type of screws that they can turn. The two most common variations are the slotted screwdriver and the Phillips head screwdriver. The cross-shaped depression in the Phillips head design allows a user to apply more torque than it is possible with slot head screwdrivers. The different parts of the screwdriver are the shank, the blade, the tip, and the handle. When working with small nails or soft wood, hold the screwdriver with your dominant hand, index finger extended. When working with bigger screws or hardwood, grip the handle fully with one hand and hold the shank with the other to steady your applied force. Use a center punch to make a pilot hole. Alternatively, you can also lightly hit the screw with a hammer. Position the screw perpendicular to your work. Keep your shoulder in line with your hand, the screwdriver, and the screw shank. Use both hands, one to hold the handle and the other to steady the shank. Whenever possible, fix the work in a vise or clamp. For brass screws, pilot holes are necessary, as brass is more malleable and can twist under pressure. Choose appropriately sized drill bits. Drill a pilot hole for the head of the screw. Go just deep enough so that the head of the screw doesn't protrude from the wooden surface. Drill a smaller hole for the thread. Without pilot holes, the screw can get stuck halfway. You need to make two holes, a shallow and wide hole to form a slot for the head of the screw, and a narrow and long hole in the middle of the first one for the thread. If the wood is resisting penetration, you can apply some wax on the screw. Position the screw on the pilot hole with the index finger and thumb of your non-dominant hand. Place the tip of the screwdriver on the head of the screw with your dominant hand. Apply light pressure. Let go of the screw and hold the shank of the screwdriver. Turn the screwdriver clockwise. After two or three turns into the wood, the screw will have caught hold. Make sure that the screw is upright. Drive the screw deeper until it is almost entirely inside the piece of wood. Make the last turns slowly. Avoid letting the head of the screw sink completely below the wood, as it will later be difficult to remove it. Place the screwdriver on the screw and apply firm, steady pressure. Twist the screwdriver clockwise and push the screw slowly into the hole. Avoid working with a wrong screwdriver. Always use a screwdriver that matches the size and shape of the screw. A small screwdriver used on a big screw lacks driving force and can slip out of the slot, chewing up the screw head. If the screwdriver is too wide, you could end up tearing the wooden surface. You have now learnt how to use a screwdriver.